Today's video is all about hypertension. I-discuss natin ang pambansang sakit ng mga tao. So if you're interested, please keep on watching. Hashtag Learn with Nurse Bay. Enjoy watching! Ano nga ba ang blood pressure? Blood pressure is the product of cardiac output and peripheral vascular resistance. Your blood pressure is recorded as two numbers. First is systolic and second is diastolic. Yung systolic is yung sa taas and yung diastolic is yung sa baba. Systolic blood pressure indicates how much pressure your blood is exerting against your artery walls when the heart beats. So yan yung pag yung nag-exert yung heart ng effort para ma-pump out yung blood papunta sa different parts of the body. And diastolic blood pressure indicates how much pressure your blood is exerting against your wall artery walls while the heart is resting between beats. So yung diastolic is yung resting of the heart. Systolic is a major risk factor of having cardiovascular diseases, lalo na yung mga 50 years above, because dahil dun sa stiffening of their artery walls, which is yung tumitigas, or accumulation of fats sa may artery wall din, tapos sa age na din siya. According sa recent studies na nirelease ng American Heart Association, na may tumataas yung risk ng death ng mga patients with ischemic heart disease and stroke na just 40 to 89 years old, with every plus 20 sa systolic, 20 millimeters of mercury sa systolic and 10 millimeters of mercury sa diastolic. Any other problems? Sasagutin natin yan. First is yung if your blood pressure is high for too long, it damage your blood vessels. Nasisira niya yung mga ugat. Then yung bad cholesterol, nag-accumulate siya dito hanggang sa patagal ng patagal. Hindi pa kayo nag lifestyle changes. Kain pa rin ng kain ng mga matataba, mga mataas yung oil, processed foods, still smoking, drinking alcohol, lagi as in araw-araw. Mga case, mga ganun yung nauubos sa isang araw. Nag-accumulate yung fats dito. Ganyan ang magiging ano. Instead of ito yung dadaanan ng mismong blood, dito na lang siya dadaan sa masikip. So ano yung ni-expect natin? Yung blood mag-exert ng effort, mag-increase yung workload niya para mabigyan ng other supply of blood and other components yung other system. So ipupush niya ng ipupush hanggang sa mahirapan. At baka ma-dislodge pa yung fats and bumara sa iba pang mga mas maliliit na ugat. Next is yung mismong wall. Pag normal ang blood pressure, ganyan lang siya. Ganyan yung pressure. Normal lang yung flow. Tapos pag mataas yung blood pressure, nasusugat niya yung wall. Nasusugat niya yung wall. Syempre pag nasugat tayo, nagkakaroon ng blood clots para mahilom yung sinusugat ng mismong blood pressure na gumaganyan. So pag nagkaroon ng blood clot dito, blood clot, may sugat, blood clot, tas mataas yung pressure, pwede ding ma-dislodge yung mismong blood clot dito at mag-travel sa different parts of the body, which is yung nagkakaroon ng stroke, mga ganun, heart attack, mga pumupunta sa lungs, baka magkaroon din na hindi makahinga yung pasyente. Nursing care planning goals for hypertensive patients. First is yung dapat sumusunod sa lifestyle changes. Hindi nakakain ng mga bawal, which is yung mga mantika and processed foods. Second is yung mag-a-adhere sa mga medications na prescribed by the physician. Tapos yung third is to prevent complications, for example, risk for stroke ka na, risk for blood clotting ka na. So, susunod ka na din doon sa mga in-advise ng doktor. Maiwasan yung mga, for example, yun nga, yung stroke, yung mga kidney failure, baka magdagdagan pa ng ibang sakit, comorbidities like diabetes, prolonged high blood pressure, kasi sa sobrang, dito nga, sabi ko, sa sobrang taas ng pressure dito, minsan yung ibang pressure, hindi na nila alam na pa ganun lang yung way nila. Yung iba is napupunta dito, napupunta doon. So, lumulobo yung part na to, lumulobo, which is yung na-form yung aneurysm. Nagiging parang may outpouch siya dito. Dahil yung mga pressure is pupunta dyan, sa sobrang lakas ng pressure na we-weaken yung wall, nagkakaroon ng bukol dito and bukol doon na pwedeng mag-burst. High blood pressure threatens your health and quality of life. Heart attack. High blood pressure damages arteries that can become blocked and prevent blood flow to the heart muscle. Stroke. High blood pressure can cause blood vessels in the brain to clog more easily or even burst. Ito po yung tinatawag na aneurysm. Heart failure. The increased workload from the high blood pressure can cause the heart to enlarge and fail to supply blood to the flow. Cardiomegaly is the enlargement of heart. Kidney disease or failure. High blood pressure can damage the arteries around the kidneys and interfere with their ability to filter blood effectively. Vision loss. High blood pressure can strain or damages blood vessels in the eyes. Sexual dysfunction. High blood pressure can lead to erectile dysfunction in men or lower libido in women. Angina. Over time, high blood pressure can lead to heart disease or microvascular disease. Angina or chest pain is a common symptom. Peripheral artery disease. Atherosclerosis caused by high blood pressure can cause a narrowing arteries in the legs, arms, stomach, and head, causing pain or fatigue. So, ito pong susunod is mga healthy and unhealthy blood pressure ranges na according to American Heart Association. Learn what's considered normal.
Blood pressure categories. Normal. If your results fall into this category, stick with heart healthy habits like following a balanced diet and getting a regular exercise. Elevated. People with elevated blood pressure are likely to develop high blood pressure unless steps are taken to control the condition. Hypertension stage 1. At this stage of high blood pressure, doctors are likely to prescribe lifestyle changes and may consider adding blood pressure medication based on your risk of atherosclerotic cardiovascular disease, such as heart attack or stroke. Hypertension stage 2. At this stage of high blood pressure, doctors are likely to prescribe a combination of blood pressure medications and lifestyle changes. Hypertensive crisis. This stage of high blood pressure requires medical attention if your blood pressure readings suddenly exceed 180 over 120, wait 5 minutes and then test your blood pressure again. If your readings are still unusually high, contact your doctor immediately. You could be experiencing a hypertensive crisis. If your blood pressure is higher than 180 over 120 and you are experiencing signs of possible organ damage such as chest pain, shortness of breath, back pain, numbness, or weakness, change in vision, or difficulty speaking, do not wait to see if your pressure comes down on its own. This is an emergency.
Sa next vlog natin eh, syempre nagsimula naman na tayo sa pambansang sakit which is yung hypertension. So magne-next naman tayo sa diabetes. So I think that's it for today's vlog. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, tap the post notification bell so that you will be notified for my next vlog. #learnwithnursebae. B be real, be you.